Good evening, everyone, and welcome to another edition of the 18 Sports Blitz. He's George Stockburger, I'm Chuck Brame, and Nick Ketter will join us in a little bit. George, we've got a big high school football game to start off tonight.
We sure do, Chuck. Horseheads hosting rival Elmira at their brand new stadium, and last spring, Blue Raiders beat the Express for the first time ever.
They did, that's right. Could they do it again? Two 1-0 teams facing off under the brand new lights in Horseheads. Elmira up 8-0 in the third and looking for more. Talon Johnson on the carry and he heads in for the score. The Express take a 14-0 lead. Horseheads would come back down 14-7 in the fourth. Alex Chrisman goes 5 yards over the middle to Tyler Johns for the TD. That ties it at 14. We are going to overtime in OT. The Blue Raiders go for a field goal, and Ben Massengale is money. He puts Horseheads in front 17-14. Last chance for Elmira. Evan Garvin sends it to the end zone, and it's broken up by Chrisman. Horseheads comes back to defeat Elmira in OT 17-14.
Number two, Tioga hosting the Seneca Indians, a matchup of 1-0 teams. Tigers, they start out in the red zone. Emmett Wood, he's going to haul in for a first down. That's the first score of the game, a touchdown. Tigers, they're going to go for the extra point kick, but they muff the snap. The ball's flipped around, and Caden Comfer, he's going to lay out the Tioga kicker. He holds them to 6 points in the first. We go later on. Gavin Fisher, he's going to air it out for Tioga. He's going to find Valentino Rossi along the sidelines. A big first down for the Tigers. Tioga, they win at home 27-14.
2-0 Waverly in action at home against Shenango Valley. No score in the first. Waverly airing it out. Joe Tommaso going deep and right on target to Brady Blauvel for a big gain and a Wolverine first down. Later in the drive, Tommaso back to pass again, but this time he's intercepted in the end zone by Owen O'Brien. A nice pick by the Warriors. Then Shenango Valley QB Donovan Tom on the keeper, and he is going to pick up a nice gain, but then he fumbles and Thomas Hand gets a hand on it and recovers for the Wolverines. Waverly moves to 3-0, 17-7. It's halftime here on the Blitz, but we still haven't even made it to the Northern Tier yet.
No, we haven't. Coming up after the break, Nick Ketter joins us with an NTL doubleheader with Canton and Troy, both in action at home. Stay with us on the 18 Sports Blitz.